Recently, a new firmware called dArkOS was released. Unlike the regular ArkOS, it's not based on Ubuntu Linux, but on Debian instead. According to posts on Reddit from people who have already tested this firmware on the R36S console, performance gains in some games can reach up to 500%. I decided to check whether that's actually true, test the firmware myself, and compare it directly with standard ArkOS. Is the performance boost really that insane? At the same time, I prepared a short guide on how to install dArkOS on the R36S console. This is for those of you who might also want to experiment and test the console's performance in your favorite games. First of all, I want to give special thanks to the developer of dArkOS, Christian Hessian, and to the entire community for creating and supporting this firmware. And just to clarify right away, all the links to the required resources and the firmware itself are in the description box. So, let's get started. First, we need to download the dArkOS firmware. On this page, you can find the latest version. We need to download the split archive made of two parts for the RG351MP console. After downloading, extract only the first part of the archive using the free app THAN ARKOS on Mac or 7-zip on Windows. By the way, you can buy the R36S on Aliexpress, and to make your purchase even more affordable, I recommend using my promo codes at checkout. You'll find the links to the console, promo codes, and additional info in the description box. Next, we need to write the firmware to an SD card. For this test, I am using a 32GB SD card. First, I format it to exFAT. I do this using Disk Utility, which is a standard Mac app. After that, I need to flash the firmware image to the SD card. For this, I usually use the free program Berliner Etcher. It's not something that's usually recommended in guides, but honestly, it has never failed me. You can use any other tool you prefer, including the command line in terminal. In one of my previous videos, I already showed how to flash an ArkOS image using the terminal on macOS. Once the flashing process is complete, we need to eject the SD card and then immediately insert it back into the computer so that the boot and EZROM's partitions are automatically mounted on the desktop. Next, we need to replace the screen file in the boot partition. In my Telegram channel, you can download an archive that contains screen files for the R36S with the original screen like mine and for the consoles with Panel 4. There are two different files for Panel 4, and it's impossible to know which one will work for you on the first try. Start with the first option, and if your screen looks something like this, remove the SD card and copy the other file into the boot partition, replacing the existing one. That one might work for you. So, I open the boot partition and copy this file here, replacing it for my original screen. After that, the SD card can be safely removed. Now insert the SD card into the first slot on the console. Turn the console on, and now we just need to wait a bit while the firmware installs itself and the console boots automatically. That's it, dArkOS is now installed on the R36S. Now I can insert the second SD card with my game collection. Next, go to the Options section, then Advanced, and at the bottom select Switch to SD2 for ROMs. And now we can finally move on to game testing and performance comparison with one of the latest versions of ArkOS for the R36S. And before we continue, please take a moment to like this video, subscribe to the channel and leave a comment. It's super important for promoting both the video and the channel. The more likes, views, and subscribers we get, the more videos I'll be able to make and share with you, and the more fun and interesting the content will become. Also, don't forget to click the bell icon so you won't miss any new videos. And if you want to support the channel even more, you can hit the like button. It helps push the video to new audiences and brings even more people into our community. Thanks a ton for your support. Let's continue. Let's start with Nintendo DS emulation. In Mario Kart, everything works exactly the same. Both firmwares show good performance, and honestly, I did not notice any difference here at all. Let's try something more demanding and compare performance on PlayStation. As you can see, the FPS is the same, around 60, and I didn't feel any difference in gameplay either. However, I remember that when playing Nintendo 64, specifically The Legend of Zelda Ocarina of Time, I experienced some discomfort during gameplay, and the visual quality wasn't great. During this comparison, I see the exact same situation both during gameplay and cutscenes, almost identical frame rates, and absolutely no 500% performance boost, not even close. Maybe I am doing something wrong and additional RetroArch settings are required? Let me know in the comments. Even in my favorite game, ReWorld, performance is below average in both firmware versions, ArkOS and dArkOS. The game stutters and it's very uncomfortable to play, which is why I personally prefer the free portmaster version of the game, which runs perfectly. Next up is PSP game performance. As usual, let's start with GTA Vice City Stories. And here, as you can see, nothing new. Both firmwares show the same performance. I wasn't trying to be skeptical, I honestly expected a miracle and thought that the Debian-based firmware would bring some improvements, but unfortunately, that's not the case. In other PSP games, the results are more or less the same. By the way, right after installation, Portmaster works out of the box, and I was even able to launch Half-Life 2. Based on my impressions, the game runs exactly the same as on ArkOS. In conclusion, I want to say that it's probably still too early to draw any serious conclusions or comparisons. dArkOS is currently being updated almost every week, and it will likely be optimized for a long time. On top of that, Aliexpress might also release its own dArkOS firmware version for the R36S someday, who knows? For now, all we can do is watch, wait, test, and look forward to what's coming. Some of you might be wondering why all of this even matters and what the real difference is. The thing is, dArkOS is based on Debian as of 2025, while ArkOS is based on Ubuntu 19.10, which as far as I know, hasn't been supported for about 5 years and uses outdated components. So in theory, dArkOS should offer better performance. On top of that, Ubuntu is a heavier operating system, while Debian Trixie, released in 2025, comes with newer and most importantly, stable libraries and utilities for running programs and games. Hopefully, that makes it a bit clearer why this is even worth talking about. And as always, I hope you enjoyed this video. Please like and subscribe to the channel. I wish you pleasant nostalgia and successful completion of your favorite games.